Morphology of egg, larva, pupa and adult of Bombyx mori. Introduction. Mulberry silkworm Bombyx mori passes through four morphologically different stages in the life cycle, namely egg, larva, pupa and adult. And hence, it is a homo metabolous insect. Except the egg stage, all the other three stages have segmented appendages, which are the specific characteristics of arthropoda. The body is divided into three regions, namely head, thorax and abdomen, which is a common features of all the insects. Now, let us know the structure of each stage. 1. Structure of the egg. A. Size, shape, weight of the eggs. The size, weight, shape and color of the egg, as well as the number of eggs per laying, that is fecundity, vary among different races and also according to the season. Larval nutrition of the mother moth and environmental conditions during egg laying. In general, the silkworm egg is small, flat, ellipsoid in shape. Also, the eggs of European races are usually large and heavy, while that of tropical polyvoltaine races is small and light. An average Indian crossbreed multivoltaine race lays about 400 eggs per laying, whose size is very small compared to the other aboriginal races. The weight of the single egg is about 0.55 to 0.6 milligram with approximately 1.075 in specific gravity. And there are about 1800 to 2000 eggs per gram. The eggs laid first are heavier than those laid later by the same moth. The eggs are flat on one side. This is called egg dimple. This side is attached to the substratum and receives a gluey secretion from the accessory glands as they pass down the common oviduct prior to oviposition. If the ovipositing moths are subjected to the too low or too high temperature, this secretion becomes irregularly deposited on all sides of the egg. It is a water soluble material and is usually removed by washing with water in preparation of loose eggs in the grainages. B. Color of the eggs. The color of the egg is a racial character. Generally, deep colored eggs are found in Japanese races, while the eggs of Chinese races are commonly light in color. Newly laid eggs are light yellow in color. White cocoon races lay paler eggs compared to the yellow cocoon races. In diapausing races, the color of the eggs changes to deep brown when they enter into the diapause. In non-diapausing races, the color does not change till the development is complete or head pigmentation stage. The egg reaches the blue egg stage one day prior to hatching. The color of the eggs also changes by season. For instance, the color is deep in summer because the pigment scatters evenly throughout the cerocell cell. On the contrary, in winter, the pigment is located at the one corner of the cell, making the color of the egg lighter until next spring, when it scatters again and the color of the egg turns deeper. C. Chorion or eggshell. The protective cover of the egg is called chorion and it has an opening called micropyle at the anterior end. The chorion is about 0.02 mm in thickness, showing racial differences. It is thickest in European races, followed by Japanese races and Chinese univoltine races, being thinnest in Chinese bivoltine ones. Even in the same egg, the thickness is different locally. In the upper view of the external forearm of an egg, the curvature of the right side is different from that of left at the end where the micropyle exists. Chorion is asymmetrical in thickness and the larva breaks open the thinner side while hatching. The chorion occupies about 10% of the eggs in weight and consists of chorionin, which is different from chitin, the major component of insect skin, rather resembling keratin, protein of wool and contains much sulfur and nitrogen. Chorion is composed of two layers, the exochorion and the endochorion. The main component of the exochorion is chorionin. It contains more sulfur and nitrogen than chitin, which is the main component of the cuticle. It is therefore considered to be related to keratin, the protein of the vertebrate skin. Some find a resemblance between chorionin and cuticulin, the substance found in the cuticulin layer of the epicuticle. Endochorion is the main layer acting as a barrier to water loss and has a wax layer below it. The expression of the follicle cells secreting the wax layer can be seen on the chorion. At the micropylar end, the chorion has a projection with a chrysanthemum-like marking and three micropylar canals. Respiratory canals are distributed throughout the chorion. D. Internal morphology of silcomex. There are two membranes beneath the chorion, the serosa and the vitelline membrane. The serosa is formed after fertilization and cleavage of zygote nuclei and migration of these nuclei to the periplasm. Initially, it is colorless but later becomes pigmented. The eggs are centriolecithal. The semi-fluid yolk is concentrated in the middle of the eggs so that the cytoplasm is pushed to the surface at the thinner layer called periplasm. At the micropylar end, the periplasm gets collected in cup-like depression of the yolk. This is called the periplasm, and the nucleus is situated in the center of the periplasm. 2. Structure of the silkworm larva. The larva of Bombyx mori, like other lepidopteran larvae, are of the cruciform or polypod type with abdominal prolex. Newly hatched larva about 3 mm long, black or dark brown in color. It has a large head and a body is densely covered with bristles and looks like a hairy caterpillar. It is popularly called ant. There are 4 pairs of tubercles, the subdorsal, supraspiracular, infraspiracular and basal tubercle, each of which carries 3 to 6 setae. As the larva grows, it becomes smoother and lighter in color due to the rapid stretching of the cuticular skin during different instars of the larval stage. The larva body is composed of the same segment as any insect's head, thorax and abdomen. The entire body is covered with a thin and elastic chitinous cuticle, which is capable of being extended considerably to permit rapid growth of the larva during any instar. The integument consists of epidermis and the cuticle over it. As the larva grows, it molds and enters into the later instars. The cuticle becomes smooth and stretched, and the setae are shed and tubercles become less prominent. The color also becomes pale. The final instar larva grows up to 10 cm in length. The body of the larva is divided into 3 regions, tegmata, that is head, thorax and abdomen. The head is formed by fusion of 6 segments, the thorax has 3 segments and the abdomen 11 segments. A. Silcom head. The head is small, hypognathous, that is mouth is ventral in position, heavily chitinized and bright brown in color. The head consists of 6 body segments fused together with a cranium. The second, fourth, fifth and sixth segments carry appendages which are modified into antennae, mandibles, maxillae and labium respectively. The skeleton of the head segments fuse with the cranium to form head plates. The apical plate is known as epicranium and is large. the epicranial suture separating it from the parietal is prominent. The other head plates or the parietals on either side of the epicranial suture and covering the front portion of the head. The clypeus lying above the mouth and divided into the frontal clypeus, post clypeus and anticlypeus. The labrum or upper lip hangs from the anticlypeus. There are 6 pairs of ocelli or larval eyes which are located behind and a little above the base of the antenna, that is 3 pairs on either side of the parietals. There is a pair of antenna formed of 5 jointed segments and these are used as sensory organs. Antennae are modified appendages of second segment and are short 3 to 5 jointed and each joint has 30 to 40 segments and numerous tactile hairs and a tactile lobe. The tactile hairs are the regions where the olfactory sense organs are located. They help in perceiving the odor of the food and help in selection of the food. If the antennae are removed, mulberry silkworm loses its olfactory sensation and start feeding on the wrong plants for some time. B. Silkworm mouthparts. The mouthparts include 1. Labrum. This is an unsegmented projection of the anticlypeus which forms the upper lip. 2. Mandibles. These are the paired appendages of the 4th cephalic segment. They are toothed and chitinized. They lie in the mouth cavity and serve to cut the mulberry leaves by a side to side action like the blades of scissors. The duct of the salivary glands open at the base of the mandibles. 3. Maxillae. These are the short paired appendages of the 5th segment. Each maxillae has a basal portion made of 2 segments, the proximal, caudo and the distal stipes. A maxillary lobe and a 3 segmented maxillary pulp are present in the stipes. Taste sensillae are located on these appendages. They help in discrimination of the taste of the food. 4. Labium. This median organ forms the lower lip. It is formed by the fusion of appendages of the last or 6th cephalic segment. The caudo and the stipes of the appendages of the 2 sides fused to form 2 median structures. The lower is lightly chitinized, mentum, and the upper is heavily chitinized, black colored, prementum. There is a median process in the distal end of the prementum called spinneret. The silk gland opens through this opening and silk exudes through the spinneret during the spinning of the cocoon. The labial pulp are short and separate and lie on either side of the spinneret. They are sensory in function. C. Silkworm thorax. The 3 segments forming the thorax are the prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. The prothorax is smaller than the meso and metathorax. The prothorax has a pair of respiratory openings, the spiracles on the lateral side. The meso and metathorax project slightly upwards and form the dorsal hump on the body of the worm. There is a dorsal eye spot in the mesothorax. Each of the thoracic segments has a pair of conical, short, 3 jointed appendages or the true legs. Each leg has a claw at the tip. The legs are not used for walking but are used for holding the mulberry leaf while feeding. D. Silkworm abdomen. Though only 9 segments are visible in the abdomen, it is formed by 11 segments. The 9th, 10th and 11th abdominal segments are fused to form apparent 9th segment, the caudal plate and the paired caudal prolex. Apart from the lower segment, paired prolex are present in the 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th abdominal segments. Each proleg is a projection of the body segment and has circular disc at the tip. A series of inwardly curved hooks are arranged in the form of semicircle on the outer edge of the disc. On the dorsum of the 8th segment is a projection called caudal horn. Each of the first 8 abdominal segments has a pair of spiracles laterally. Each spiracle has a sieve plate to prevent the entry of the dust particles. A thick block circular rim called peritrim and two valves enclosing the respiratory opening or slit. The spiracles are of the atriate type. The lowest spiracle is largest. The larva has a number of projections or nodules all over the body and markings on the skin. The number and distribution of the nodules as well as the nature of the markings are racial characters. E. Sex differences in larva. The two sexes can be distinguished from each other by sex markings developed in the 4th and 5th instar larvae. The female larva has a pair of sex marks on the ventral side of the 8th and 9th abdominal segments called Ishivata's foreglands and Ishivata's hind glands respectively. Ishivata's foreglands later become modified to form bursa copulatrix and receptaculum seminis. Ishivata's hind gland become part of the posterior region of the oviduct and accessory glands. The male larva has a single median opening at the junction of the 8th and 9th segment called opening of Herold's gland. It becomes the seminal duct and ejaculatory duct of the adult. However, these can be seen clearly only in the freshly molted larvae. Hence, special races with marker genes to the sex chromosome are used in silicone breeding stations and grainages to separate the sexes at the larval stage. The sex marker genes are located on the W chromosome of the female. 3. Structure of the pupa. The pupa mouths occurs in the cocoon spun by the final instar larva. Pupa can be seen only by cutting open the cocoons. Pupae are soft and white soon after molt, but they become hard brown with tanning of the pupal cuticle. The color of the pupal cuticle, particularly its compound eyes and wing pads, get changed in color with the differentiation of the adult. Usually, age of the cocoon can be roughly estimated by cross-examination of the color of the pupa. The pupa is a non-motile and non-feeding stage. During this stage, the larval organs are destroyed and adult organs are differentiated. It is divided into three regions: head, thorax, and abdomen. A. Pupal head. The head is small, situated on the ventral side of the thorax. It has a pair of compound eyes, a pair of large antennae, and vestigial mouth parts. All are non-functional. Pupal thorax. The thorax is a large and prominent. Two pairs of wing pads and three pairs of limb buds are immovably pressed against the body on the ventral side and enclosed in a chitinous case. C. Pupal abdomen. The abdomen is composed of 11 segments, but only 9 are visible dorsally. 7 pairs of spiracles are represented in the first 7 segments of the abdomen, and of these, the last pair is non-functional. D. Sex differences in pupa. The sex markings are more clearly visible in the pupa than the larva. The female pupa is larger with broader abdomen and the male pupa is thinly built with narrower abdomen. Also, the female pupa has a vertical line in the center of the 8th abdominal segment on the ventral side, whereas in the male, there is a small round spot on the 9th segment. 4. Structure of adult. The silk moth have lost their flight due to continuous domestication for several centuries. They do not feed during their lifetime, which lasts for only 3 to 6 days. The size of the moth is about 4 into 2 cm. The entire body and the wings are covered with epidermal scales. Here also, just like that of larva and pupa, The body is divided into three regions, namely head, thorax, and abdomen. Adult head. The head is small and hypognathous. The paired compound eyes are prominent on the side of the head. On the inner side of the eye, a pair of bipectinate antenna arise. The proboscis is coiled and is non-functional. P. Adult thorax. Of the three thoracic segments, the mesothorax is the most prominent. The cuticle of the thoracic segment is hardened to form sclerotis. The dorsal targite, the ventral sternite, the lateral pleuritis are present in each segment. Both the mesothoracic and metathoracic segments bear a pair of wings. The four wings overlap the hind wings. The wings are pale colored and fully covered with scales. Ventrally, each of the thoracic segment bear a pair of legs. Each leg possesses five jointed segments, namely coxa, trochanter, femur, tibia, and tarsus respectively. The tarsus ends in a pair of claws. C. Adult abdomen. The abdominal segments are also covered with scales. Eight segments are visible in the abdomen of the male and only seven in the female. There are six pairs of spiracles in the abdomen situated laterally. D. Sex differences in the adult. Morphologically, the female and male can be easily distinguished in the adult stage. The female is pale in color and possesses comparatively smaller antennae. Its body and abdomen are fatter and larger with seven segments, and it is generally less active than male moth, where it is long, narrow, with eight visible segments. At the caudal end, the male moth has a pair of hooks known as harpus, whereas the female moth has a knob-like projections with sensory hairs. These differences helps to a large extent in separating the sexes for preparation of hybrid eggs. Conclusion. Mulberry silkworm Bombyx mori is a holometabolous insect which passes through four morphologically different stages in its life cycle, namely egg, larva, pupa, and adult. Except the egg stage, all the other three stages have segmented appendages. The eggs of Bombyx mori are flat on one side. The weight of a single egg is about 0.55 to 0.6 milligram. The color of the egg depends on race as well as season. The protective covering of the egg is called the chorion, and it has an opening called micropyle at the anterior end. Chorion is composed of two layers, the exochorion and the endochorion. The larvae are cruciform or polypod type with abdominal prolex. Newly hatched larvae is about 3 mm long, black or brown or dark brown in color. The body has three segments, namely head, thorax, and abdomen. The head is hypognathous, heavily chitinized and bright brown in color. The mouth parts include labrum, mandibles, maxillae, and labium. The thorax is divided into pro, meso, and metathorax. Each of the thoracic segments has a pair of conical, short, three-jointed appendages or the true legs. The legs are used for holding the mulberry leaf while feeding. Each thoracic segment has a pair of spiracles laterally. The abdomen is formed by 11 segments, only 9 segments are visible. However, 9th, 10th and 11th abdominal segments are fused to form the apparent 9th segment, the caudal plate and the paired caudal prolex. On the dorsum of the 8th segment is a projection called caudal horn. Each of the first 8th abdominal segment possesses a pair of spiracles laterally. Sex can be determined in the 4th and 5th instar larvae. The female larvae has a pair of sex marks on the ventral side of the 8th and 9th abdominal segments called Ischiwata's foreglands and Ischiwata's hindglands respectively. The male larvae has a single median opening at the junction of the 8th and 9th segments called opening of the Herald's gland. Pupa can be seen only by cutting open the cocoons. Pupae are soft white soon after molt, but they become hard and brown with tanning of the pupal cuticle. The silk moths have lost their flight due to continuous domestication for several centuries. They do not feed during their lifetime, which lasts for only 3 to 6 days. With this, we come to an end of the chapter, Morphology of Egg, Larva, Pupa and Adult of Bombyx mori. Thank you.